Hey guys, it's your boy Tony with a new video. I'm sure you noticed that I've been hitting the gym lately, huh? Yeah. No, not at all, man. Not at all. You look just like you've been for the past days, man. Okay. That's embarrassing, but you ever notice that? I'll just start with the video. So today, I'm going to talk about some questions you should ask yourself if you're starting to learn a new language. So let's hop into it. So first of all, you need to ask yourself, why exactly am I studying this language? Is it because I want to impress this Latino girl at my school? Or maybe it is a part of your school curriculum and you just have to pass in order to be promoted to the next class. Or maybe you're learning a foreign language because you're actually interested in foreign cultures and you want to meet new people. Then you are the perfect place. Subscribe to my channel so that you won't miss any of my future videos. But jokes aside, it is very important that your reason should be strong enough in order to keep you working even when the language becomes harder. Secondly, you need to ask yourself, what are your goals? What are your goals? Most people say fluency as a goal. I don't know, what exactly is fluency? Fluency could mean something different to me. That's what fluency means to me. To me, fluency could maybe be ordering something in a coffee shop. Excusez-moi, je voudrais un thé au citron et aussi un petit gâteau à la crème. Merci beaucoup. On the other hand, fluency to you could mean being able to attend a conference on rocket science and understand everything that is being said. I don't know. So instead, I would advise you to come up with some precise long-term goals and short-term steps to be able to achieve these goals. Lastly, how much time do I have and how much money do I have available? This is very important because the answer to this question will help you choose the right studying method for the language. For example, if you have a lot of money, then you can register for a language course. Or you can even fly to the country in which the language is spoken. That would be a lot more exciting. On the other hand, if you don't have that much money, then what you can do is you can read books, watch videos, or even find a language partner whom you can practice the language with. So now I would like to thank you for watching. Don't forget to like this video and to subscribe so that you wouldn't miss any of my future videos. And I would like to know in the comments below, what are your answers to these questions? So have a nice day and see you in my next video. Peace.